Hey guys, welcome to Cook with Nancy. Today I'm going to show you guys how to make this easy and delicious fluffy, pillowy naan or flatbread recipe that is made with suji or semolina. If you're new to my channel, welcome. If you haven't subscribed, go ahead and hit the subscribe button right now, that way you don't miss on upcoming videos. I will show you the small tips and tricks how to make this delicious and soft pillowy bread. To start off, here in a food processor or a high speed blender, I'm adding 1 cup of fine semolina. If you don't have fine semolina, that's fine. Go ahead and add the regular semolina to the blender. To this, I'm going to add 2 to 3 tablespoons of a thick yogurt. If you don't have a thick yogurt, that's okay. Go ahead and add the regular yogurt, around 2 to 3 tablespoons. This is what gives this beautiful soft pillowy bread. So make sure you add the yogurt. To this, I'm adding 3/4 of a cup warm milk. Go ahead and blend them for 30 to 35 seconds until it's nice and smooth. The semolina would never be a smooth paste, so that's fine. It will be still have coarse texture. That's what we are looking for. Go ahead and add another 2 to 3 tablespoons of milk to wash it off. 1 teaspoon of salt and 1 1/2 teaspoon instant yeast. Go ahead and mix them until it's all well combined. To this, I'm going to add all-purpose flour. Now I'm adding 2 cups of all-purpose flour, but you can add 1 cup of all-purpose flour and 1 cup of whole wheat flour or completely whole wheat flour to be on a healthier side. Now go ahead and mix them in a spatula or a spoon until the dough just comes together. Then go ahead and knead them with your hand until the dough comes together. But the dough will be sticky. Don't get tempted to add more flour. We want the dough to be sticky. Now I'm adding 1 teaspoon of oil. Go ahead and just mix them until the dough all is well combined with the oil. Now I'm going to go ahead and rest it by covering with a kitchen towel or a clean wrap for around 45 minutes to an hour until it doubles in size. As you can see, it's doubled in size. Now I'm gonna not punch down too much of the air. Just gently push down some air and then take out the dough from the box or container and roll it down into a smooth, soft roll and cut into 6 equal parts. If you want to add some flour on the surface, go ahead and add that. Just don't overdo with the flour. Now go ahead and roll this, go ahead and make into a soft, smooth ball. Now, when you roll it into a smooth ball, make sure there is no cracks, because when we fry them on the pan, it will not trap any air and it's not going to create any pocket. So make sure you have a smooth ball. Cover it for another 5 to 7 minutes. After, when you are ready to roll the dough out, just gently press it down without pushing too much of air. Again, the air is very important, so just don't push too much of air out of your dough when you are rolling as well. Go ahead and roll it until you have a desired shape or size, and once it is done, I'm going to add it to the hot tawa. My tawa is nice and hot. Now the temperature I've reduced into medium high heat. You don't want it to cook on high heat, it will burn and it will not cook through. So you want it to cook this on a medium high heat and just cook them by flipping as necessary until it's nice and pillowy and fluffy. As you can see, it's nicely puffed up. That's what we are looking for. This is why we want to keep the air trapped inside. Even when you're rolling in, you don't want to push too much of the air out, then you will never get the result of the bread with puffing up. Continue to do this with the rest of the dough that you got, and make sure you cover the rest of the dough that you have in hand. So when you're cooking the bread, just make sure you cover the rest of them so that it does not dry out. Because if it dries out when you cook, it's definitely going to break, crack. It's not going to puff up. So now once it is all done, I'm going to transfer into a plate. Go ahead and apply some butter or oil or even a ghee. Just a little bit, just to keep them nice and soft. You can stir this bread at room temperature. It will stay soft and it will not dry out, and I promise about that. You can serve this as a sandwich bread. You can serve this as a pita bread because it creates a beautiful pocket, or just serve as it is. I hope you enjoy watching this video. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. I will see you soon in my next video. Till then, take care guys. Bye.